Okay, look, Siege is tough. It's a hard game for your brain to handle, but look, your brain needs food just like your stomach, all right? I went to college.
Knowledge!
So why don't we combine helping you get better at Siege with providing food for your brain, yeah? Excellent. Welcome to Inside the Mind of a Champion, the brain food you need to get better at Siege. Guys, I finally made it to- Nope. Hard stuck plat this season. I suck. But guess what? We interviewed two real champions, one of whom won NIL this past season, and one of whom took home the hammer from the Siege Invitational.
It's Pikachu!
Now that SI is over, get ready for stage 2 of the NIL starting June 15th. Go ahead and follow R6 Esports NA for the latest news on the league, and click the link in the description to follow on Twitter. Consider supporting your favorite esports teams by getting the league bundles and team items directly in-game. For every regional league set or team item sold, 30% of the net revenue will be distributed amongst the respective organizations. Today, I sat down with Julio from NIP and Kino from Oxygen, two amazing players who are hot off massive wins. We'll first begin with Julio, the most recent victor to claim the SI Hammer, winning the biggest Rainbow Six tournament to date, and now world champion. He told me about one of his favorite rounds from the tournament to help you, the viewer, understand the stakes involved and thought process going on in his head at the time. As always, if you enjoy the content, like and subscribe, and be sure to give these guys a follow on their socials.
Yeah, that was the last round against MIBR on the last map on the winners bracket, basically the winners bracket final. So yeah, that was a really important round that decide who you go to the grand final. And yeah, we were attacking cash, and they won the other bomb side. So yeah, they needed to defend cash, and yeah, just a simple garage take. I think we did, if not mistaken. Yeah, just do some mavericks. Just they didn't reinforce the garage, so it was easier for us, you know. We went to the garage pretty fast, and yeah, they had a thing in mind, like stop the plants with Tashanka, smoke, etc. It's force, and yeah, that was not an aggressive take, you know, for the last round. They were not like that aggressive, so that was good for us. Yeah, we just breaking gadgets, breaking the walls, and doing the default threats, basically. So in this round, Muse had a good drone on the, I don't know how to say English, servidor, I think. And yeah, he was doing, show it right now. He was doing a really good call out, you know, for us to do grenades from above. So yeah, it was really good. Look, they got a kill, Muzi got the refrag, and it was a 4v4. Their threat was like, just stop the plant, but we knew that, because it's a common thing on this bomb site, and because of Tashanka. So we just say, yeah, let's push them, you know, let's push these stairs and don't fall to their plant. Yeah, Pino did a great grenade, because of Muzi's drone, you know, we were... That's why it's good to maintain calm, you know, even on the last round of the last map. So maintain calm, doing good call out. Yeah, throw another nade to get the frag, but Kamikaze got it. And that was it. We are now planning the rush, you know. I'm going through the stairs and then going to the corridor. Just kill the Stashank, and then they are only on cash, you know. They're going to stay on cash, and that's not good for them on this bomb site. Yeah, Kamikaze baited some plants, you know, just to confuse them that we're gonna plant, you know. So yeah, Zofia Stone and then the rush. Synchronization, yeah, they got the kill. They are only cash now, they're trapped. One guy tried to C4 Kamikaze, but he's not even planting. And yeah, that's the round.
Look how excited y'all are. That is goosebumps,
last
bro.
Last round, man. Let's 8-7, it's a different feeling, you know.
Absolutely. So, like, would you say that was your favorite moment of the tournament, or was the actual grand final?
We had a lot of great moments. Of course, the last round of the final it's awesome. But like, if I get just the rounds, you know, not the importance of the match. I think that the one or that it was a lot. Like, we won against BDS like 8-7-2, against FaZe 8-7, so we had a lot of good moments on this tournament for sure.
So cool. And how close are you with the other Brazilian teams? Like, was that kind of like friends going up against friends?
Yeah, for sure. We are really close friends with MIBR. Like, we were trash talking them, and they were trash talking us, and like the fans got mad at them, you know. Our fans got mad at them, but like, we are all friends. We are just like having fun, you know? And yeah, that was awesome.
We now move on to Kino, one of Pro League's newest additions, a true star able to frag with just about any operator. He won NAL last season and will be looking to do the same for Stage 2 starting up on June 15th. He told me about one of his favorite rounds from the NAL play days.
All right, so right now at this point, we're doing a cool vibes hold because we know they love doing a red bar or sunrise take. So they brought the buck to buck below us and reinforced the two hookah walls towards cool vibes, and I'm playing on cool vibes with the shotgun. Yaw gets first picked from big window. It was a 5v3. We needed picks here. So I quick picked this guy big window. I saw him and it just happened. That shot, I landed it. I'd say it was a little bit of luck. And then I killed the second guy trying to get the refrag. I heard someone below me. I got the kill as well. And then it was a 1v2. Fox was full HP, holding the hallway. Man was planning. I had the intel, so I went below, tried shotgun him. And then he was repositioning. We didn't have any cams on him, but we had an idea of where he was. So we were just waiting for him to start the plant, so me and Fox could double up and swing on him. We knew he was planning around the hookah wall. I walked into cool vibes. I downed him, but Fox stole my kill. So, yeah, I mean, it happens. It was a good round overall.
Dang, bro. Yeah, so first of all, I remember seeing this quick peek on the big window and just thinking, what on earth, what did you see in that moment?
So everyone usually talks about how LAN, you can't really swing because of the ping. You gotta, like, hold an angle.
Mm-hmm.
I disagree with that. I think, like, you can still quick peek. You can still do peaks like that. And that is just the proof right there. I guarantee that Eclipse did not see me at all on those peaks.
Absolutely deleted. So these two walls next to cool vibes, y'all have reinforced instead of a rotate. Yes. Why?
Because I can play cool vibes without dying from hookah bauk, because we knew they were doing a vertical push from sunrise. So that was a counter strat.
Makes sense. Yeah, so you just played those since you had, like, what, two ADSs, and so it was, like, a pretty comfortable position just to, I mean, pushing those when a defender has a shotgun on those stairs is pretty difficult already, so.
Exactly. I had two ADSs, a shotgun, and I had a yokai right above the cool vibe stairs.
That's so exciting. So, yeah, so as far as NAL goes, I mean, it just seemed like you guys kind of swept through that. Did you guys just feel like you had, like, this high momentum the entire time, or was it difficult at all?
We won the first two games, and then we lost two in a row to Disrupt and Sonics. And then we talked about it. We spent a whole week talking about our mistakes instead of, like, making new strats and stuff like that. And then we fixed everything, and we won every other game.
Incredible.
Yeah, I would say it was a little bit of momentum. We were all hyped. My first season, Yogg's first season. We gotta prove ourselves, you know?
That's it for today, guys. Thank you very much for watching. If you enjoyed the video, be sure to leave a like and comment down below which pro you would like to hear from next. Now that SI is over, don't forget to prepare for Stage 2 of the NAL starting June 15th. You'll get the latest news on the league by following R6 Esports NA on Twitter, and you can do so by clicking the link in the description. Consider supporting your favorite esports teams by getting the league bundles and team items directly in-game. For every regional league set or team item sold, 30% of the net revenue will be distributed amongst the respective organizations. Take it easy, guys, and I'll see you all in the next one.